the skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide. Well, nobody's interested in learning but the teacher. Segregation, determination, demonstration, integration.
Good morning and welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. You know, we're all concerned with rebuilding Detroit, how it is rebuilt, who's going to rebuild it. One of our major problems in Detroit is actually access to capital, access to loans. This week, we're taking diversion from politics. We're going a different direction, and I'm going to introduce you to Capital Impact Partners. I'm here in the New Center, and I'm here with Melinda Clemens. Melinda, how are you? Thank you for welcoming us in today. Take me in a new direction. First of all, you're a graduate of Cass Tech.
I am a graduate of Cass Tech, and thank you for having me on the show. So Capital Impact Partners, we are a national nonprofit community development financial institution, which basically means that we have a mandate to lend in underserved communities across the country. And so we're headquartered in Arlington. We have our office here in Detroit and another
that
one
would
in
be Arlington, Virginia?
Arlington, Virginia.
Uh-huh.
Yep. But we lend nationwide.
Really?
Yes.
Tell me more. Where does the money come for Capital Impact Partners?
So it comes from various different sources. So we have philanthropic contributions. We have support from the CDFI.
What is a CDFI for the
Community
people?
Development Financial Institution. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Fund that supports us and private. And a lot of times we can also have public contributions, public company contributions such as Chase that can invest in us and then we can reinvest those assets.
So are you part of that big Chase thing that Jamie Dimon announced?
We are part of the $100 million commitment to the city of Detroit. And so we received $30 million of that, and it's called the Detroit Neighborhood Fund, and we've completely depleted it, except for a couple million dollars, so it's been very successful.
Time out. One of the big knocks against the Duggan administration, against Detroit, is that there's no development in the neighborhoods. What in the world have you spent $30 million on, and where can we go see it?
So it's across the city of Detroit. It's not just in the neighborhoods, so some of it is in Midtown, some of it is in West Village. It depends on where the projects are. So I think, just backing up a little bit, there has been a lot of controversy about how you can invest in neighborhoods and how assets go to downtown versus going to the neighborhoods. And I think they can go in both places. I mean, that's really part of the lending strategy we have.
And I'm glad you think that, but does that really happen?
Well, there's a lot of people who believe that. There are a lot of lenders and other community development financial institutions that believe that going into the neighborhoods is the next step. So, for example, we have clustered development in the West Village area. We're looking to go into the Livernois and Six Mile area this year. We're doing projects spanning out east from Eastern Market. So there are a lot of different neighborhoods that you can go into. Now, Detroit is made up of 50-something neighborhoods, right? You can't go into all of them at the same time, but you can make a strategic move into each of them.
East of Eastern Market, you mean all that vacant land that Mr. Pulte left us? That's been totally cleared?
Some of the vacant land that's over there. So we definitely don't announce any of our projects until we have our loans outstanding, but we are looking at projects in the Eastern Market
area. Well, it definitely
has
the coolest police station. No, I'm serious. They took that school and redid it and looked
great. They did.
And then you have Delta Prep Academy's football field over there. So you've got all this vacant land, and you've got these two nice structures. This is east of the Eastern Market, east of the northern part of the DeQuinder Cut. When we come back, I want to get into a little bit more of the detail of Capital Impact Partners, and I want to talk a little bit more about that, how you spent that $30 million. I mean, because people wouldn't believe it. They wouldn't believe it. So you don't mind getting into detail?
Absolutely.
Not afraid of the big bad wolf?
I'm not afraid.
All right, Melinda, we'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, it's about development and reshaping our city. Stay tuned.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team One, only at the DMC.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
Bricker Tunis Furs is having a gigantic liquidation moving sale. We're moving in March, but the sale is on now. 50 to 80% off everything.
Bricker Tunis Furs is moving after 45 years, and it's a good thing.
I love it. What a deal.
Mink, sheared mink, fox, chinchilla, leathers, and accessories, women's and men's.
Check out this python jacket.
Bricker Tunis Furs is moving, and everything is 50 to 80% off.
No other furrier can beat our quality or our prices.
This fur sale's fantastic.
Thank you.
50 to 80% off everything.
I'm buying this.
But I saw it first.
Don't worry, ladies. There's plenty more to choose from.
Don't wait. Buy now, save now. 50 to 80% off everything. Bricker Tunis Furs in West Bloomfield. 248-855-9200. 248-855-9200.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
Groundbreaking. Life-saving. History-making. The new DMC Heart Hospital, summer 2014. The beat goes on.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're here with Melinda Clemens of Capital Impact Partners. You were telling me how you spent the $30 million.
So, we spent most of the $30 million. We still have projects that are underway, either in underwriting or they're being reserved. And so, those include Eastern Market Project. It does include a Midtown Project. It includes two West Village projects.
What Eastern Market Project? Just thought I'd ask.
We'll wait until it closes, and then I'll let you know.
So is it in the market proper or east of the market?
It is east of the market.
Okay, good.
East of the market.
Continue,
and so,
please.
And then we have a project that we're definitely looking at, and it's going to be a huge project on the Livernois and 7 Mile area. And besides just, so let me back up a little bit.
But how can you put a huge project there when you have existing buildings and you have residential behind it all?
Huge project in that the volume, the dollars that are going to be invested in the project. And mm-hmm. so there are, you can certainly retrofit buildings that are already mm-hmm. there mm-hmm. that can complement the area.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that sounds interesting because Livernois and 7 is an amazing area. You've got definitely the population density there. And you've got the
Avenue
business.
Avenue of Fashion.
You've got the Avenue of Fashion.
You've got the universities up the
right.
street.
You got everything. And you got those darn berms. And you have those protected bike lanes. But we won't get into that. Continue, please. What else?
So besides the Detroit Neighborhood Fund, we also have the Wilbur Corridor Investment Fund. And that's when I came over to Capital Impact. And mm-hmm. so that's another $30 million fund that's backed by Kresge and other investors. Mm-hmm. And it was made to really start spurring economic development along the Wilbur Corridor in the Midtown area, mm-hmm. not just in sort of the downtown area. Mm-hmm. And so we were able to do several projects with mm-hmm. those as well. And so George Stewart. I don't know if you know him.
Oh, I know George.
Wilbur Garden Theater, mm-hmm. Richard Hosey, we did Kirby Lofts. Mm-hmm. We've also financed Nalia Commons. We've done a lot. We're working on the Scott Mansion now for Joel Landy. Mm-hmm. But I think it's important for us to note that we don't just do mixed-use development. So we focus on other loans as well. So things that really help underserved populations. So we lend to charter schools, federally qualified healthcare centers, mm-hmm. low income senior population.
Which federally qualified health centers?
Not in the city of Detroit.
Oh, not
so
Detroit,
we have a nationwide presence.
Oh, okay.
We have a nationwide. Low income housing for seniors. So we help finance the Greenhouse Project for mm-hmm. Presbyterian Villages of Michigan.
Mm-hmm. What was that?
So that was a project to, it's a new model in aging in which you have a cluster of development and homes together for seniors so they don't feel like they're being institutionalized, but they still can share some of the common resources.
Okay, so like some of the retirement communities that are in Florida, but on a
Absolutely.
lower income scale.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So we do many different things. We financed the new Imperial Supermarket that's over on Schaefer.
Let me tell you about Imperial Supermarket for a second. That thing, the expansion and the rebuilding of it, it's like somebody dropped a spaceship right there at Schaefer and Linden. Mm-hmm. The thing I like about the owners of the Imperial Market is that they hire from the community. You walk in there and the cashiers look like they would mean anybody from the neighborhood, and it causes neighborhood synergy. I think that is a good project. You could never logically think anybody would really ever rebuild a market right there. I mean, because the only thing there is Comcast down the street and a mm-hmm. Couple other things, but those guys are really a shining beacon of light. And I hope it spills over to the neighborhood north of it. I really do.
And that's the type of projects that we look for, right? So in 2000 and from 2000.
I want you to hold that thought. We got to get ready to go to break.
Okay.
When we come back, I want you to come back and start with in 2000. All right.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we'll be right back from Capital Impact Partners in North Midtown, the new center.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team One, only at the DMC.
If you or a loved one needs help, call the Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority at 1-800-241-4949. The Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority is your provider for services when you need a hand. We provide services for your whole family in substance abuse, autism services, and parent support. We are there to help with people suffering from depression, anxiety, and those with developmental disabilities. We can assist you with a variety of your mental health care needs. Housing placement for the homeless, job placement, and prescription coverage. As the largest mental health care organization in the state, it is our job to care for you from the neck up. We are the source for all your mental health needs. We are there for you and your entire family. Call us at 1-800-241-4949 or visit our website at dwmha.com.
Always there when I need it. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal with him. He was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Rolster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he will definitely fight for you.
I'm Wayne County Treasurer Eric Sabree, and we offer taxpayers a new, free, and convenient way to make delinquent tax payments. We have taken action by joining a kiosk network located in Rite Aid pharmacies and many other locations throughout Metro Detroit. There are more than 25 locations where payments can be made at kiosks, and more locations are coming soon. We have several kiosks located in our offices to make your payments easier. It is very important for people to stay current on their payment plans. The kiosks accept credit cards, checks or cash, and payments take just a few minutes with a simple touchscreen instruction. More than 5,000 people have used the kiosk to make payments, or look up their payment plan without having to travel downtown. My office is pleased to have brought this safe, convenient, and free option to you to make staying current on your payment plans easier. Please visit WCTkiosk.com for a list of locations. You can also pay delinquent taxes online at treasurer.waynecounty.com or by calling 313-224-5990.
Hello, I'm Dr. Shauna Diggs, and welcome to Cosmetic Dermatology.
As Michigan's leader in comprehensive skin health and rejuvenation, board-certified dermatologist Dr. Shauna Ryder Diggs and the entire Cosmetic Dermatology team take a caring, customized approach to skin care. The Cosmetic Derm team effectively treats skin diseases and autoimmune diseases, such as lupus. State-of-the-art laser technology is utilized in hair removal, tattoo removal, and skin peels. To learn more, visit our website, Cosmetic Dermatology, where science and beauty meet.
Groundbreaking, life-saving, history-making. The new DMC Heart Hospital, summer 2014. The beat goes on.
Detroit Wants to Know is sponsored by the AFPD, the voice of independent retailers.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. This week we're in the New Center area. We're talking with Melinda Clemens of Capital Impact Partners. I cut you off before you're about to go into the details. Go ahead.
So I will say from 2010 to 2000 through last year, we've done over $100 million worth of loans. And most of that's been mixed use. And so now we're really working on...
So you're telling me you've done $100 million worth of loans inside of Detroit?
Inside of Detroit.
Within we've the last actually year.
From 2010 to 2016.
Okay.
And so last year, we've done $30 million worth of loans mm-hmm. in the city of Detroit, and we have a pipeline of $40 million. The year before that, we did $25 million. And so if you take from when we began lending in 2006, but really seriously started lending in 2009, we've done almost $200 million of projects.
Is that anywhere listed so people can actually see the impact that Capital Impact Partners is listed?
So we do have a publication, and I'll get that for you. And also, you can go to our website, which is capitalimpact.org, and it has some of our studies under our Detroit focus.
Really? Okay, I mean, I think because people would like to see that. I mean, because right now, like we started in the first segment, the big issue is downtown versus the neighborhoods.
Mm-hmm.
And people need to see that there's actually something going on, especially during the time period of 2013 through 2016, what the investment really has been.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that'll answer a lot of people's questions, but continue.
Now, I don't want to say that the investment in the neighborhoods has been as much as it has mm-hmm. been in the Midtown area.
But at least there's
but
some.
At least it's moving in that direction, and that's a key focus for Capital Impact going mm-hmm. forward.
Mm-hmm.
We want to make sure that our investments create density, but they also help create vibrant neighborhoods that are inclusionary. So we don't just do projects that are just for the new Detroiters or the current Detroiters. We do projects that support both populations. And so we closed on a project a couple of months ago that is 100% affordable.
Mm-hmm.
And it's farther north than this. And so that's something that we're really excited about. We are working currently on a strategy that is deeply affordable units that are going to be in the neighborhood, so below 50% AMI.
For the people in cheap seats, explain what AMI is.
It is aggregate median income.
And that's calculated how?
That's calculated taking three different counties in Wayne County, Macomb, and then also the city of Livonia, averaging them, and then saying this is what people normally average would make.
Okay.
And it has a rental rate component to it as well. And mm-hmm. so, for example, it may say if you're doing 80% of what this average should be, mm-hmm. then rent should be X amount of dollars.
Mm-hmm.
Well, those are still really high because if you look at the city yes. of Detroit's population, 50% are under the poverty level.
Right.
And they still deserve the same type of housing and services that people that are above that
mm-hmm.
poverty level deserve. And that's the kind of things that we're working to combat.
Okay. Let's continue with the detail. describe to me how you would put a major deal together. I've only got a couple seconds left, but like, how complex was the Garden Theater project? You mentioned my good friend George Stewart. How complex was that?
Very
with
complex.
With the parking lot and all the frontage and everything. How does that happen? How long does it take to do something like that?
Very complex, and it takes years to bring those type of deals together. It could take 2 years for a transaction to come together because you have so many different participants. Mm-hmm. So you may have the lead lender, which would be Capital Impact. You may have other partners, other CDFIs involved, like Invest Detroit. The City of Detroit may be involved. The mm-hmm. Michigan Economic Development Corporation may be involved too. And so there are so many different layers in the of financing in each transaction that it's pretty complex, and it does take time to bring it together. I think the key is that the CDFIs in the Detroit community mm-hmm. really work hard to make those projects work and to continue the economic growth that's taking place now.
Okay. We've got to take a break, but we'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're learning. I sure am. We'll be right back.
Always there when I need it. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal with him. He was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Roster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he will definitely fight for you.
I'm Wayne County Treasurer Eric Sabree, and we offer taxpayers a new, free, and convenient way to make delinquent tax payments. We have taken action by joining a kiosk network located in Rite Aid pharmacies and many other locations throughout Metro Detroit. There are more than 25 locations where payments can be made at kiosks, and more locations are coming soon. We have several kiosks located in our offices to make your payments easier. It is very important for people to stay current on their payment plans. The kiosks accept credit cards, checks or cash, and payments take just a few minutes with a simple touchscreen instruction. More than 5,000 people have used the kiosk to make payments or look up their payment plan without having to travel downtown. My office is pleased to have brought this safe, convenient, and free option to you to make staying current on your payment plans easier. Please visit WCTKiosk.com for a list of locations. You can also pay delinquent taxes online at treasurer.waynecounty.com or by calling 313-224-5990.
We got our dream home at a dream price.
It's buildingdetroit.org.
This was the house that was meant to be.
We actually have a house. I mean, this is our house.
Register to bid, attend an open house, buildingdetroit.org. Welcome home.
Now, see more homes for sale than ever at buildingdetroit.org, including Own It Now homes, online at prices from $1,000. Just go to the Own It Now page at buildingdetroit.org.
No other restaurant in Detroit is getting more attention for their award-winning food and service than the Detroit Seafood Market. And not to be missed is their spectacular Sunday brunch. Omelets made to order, roast beef carvings, fried catfish, and wonderful homemade desserts. Just $30 for all you can eat and two complimentary champagne mimosas. There's also a bistro-style brunch served on Saturdays for $15. The Detroit Seafood Market, located in Paradise Valley.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you this week from Capital Impact Partners. I'm talking to Melinda Clemens. We've talked about the present. We've talked about the past. Tell me about the future.
The future is exciting in the city of Detroit. And so what we want to do is continue to build on the momentum that we've had. And so we've done lending in the Midtown area. We've started to go into the neighborhoods. We want to continue to dive into the neighborhoods with supportive services and lending. But also we want to do, as I mentioned before, lending in a truly affordable way. So lending for low-income individuals that can stay at various developments that we have. But also, we're working on a program to support developers of color. And so if you look at the equity in the city
you mean
of Detroit.
More than Mike Bird, more than Chris Jackson, more than, what's the old man's name? More than Cullen DuBose?
Yes, more than them. And so while there's
more
definitely
than the one hand.
While there's definitely a place and a need for them in the community, there's mm-hmm. also a place and a need to support younger developers. Teach them how to develop, show them the process, so that way they can build assets for themselves and also learn a skill and participate in the economic development that's taking place.
But it's always a chicken or the egg thing with development, because you've got to have some cash first before you even walk to a capital impact partners.
You do have to have some cash, and you do have to have a little bit of experience, but you don't have to have a lot of cash. And so we understand that there's a challenge in raising capital to start a project, but we also understand that a developer has to have something in the project as well. Mm-hmm. So while we traditionally may ask for 20% equity in a project, we're working on projects where we're working on financing that would only require 10% equity. And you can use grants or supports by foundation to account for some of that.
I like to hear that, because one of the major knocks in the city is that since the death of Don Barden, nobody's really getting anything, all right? Everything that's being gotten has already been gotten. You know what I'm saying?
Do you know my friend Cliff Brown?
I know Cliff Brown.
Okay, we're supporting his project.
Okay.
And so that's a very good a testament to sort of what we're trying to build out on a larger scale,
mm-hmm.
right? So we want to take developers who have a little bit of experience and give them the capacity and the skill set to be the lead developers on projects. And there's more to come. We're still working on that,
mm-hmm.
but it's definitely going to be an inclusionary developer program.
Let's talk about how people get into your pipeline. What's the first step?
First step is to call me.
And what's the number?
The number is 313-230-1119. Tell me a little bit about your project. Tell me who you are, your experience, where it's located, and we can take it from there.
Okay, that's what we want to hear. That's what we want to hear. I mean, because the big knock is it's downtown and everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
The other knock is that Detroit is a set of islands, and you swim between the islands. When you go between the islands, there are sharks, the shark-infested waters. And we need to end that.
We're definitely trying to be part of that solution, not part of that problem.
Okay.
And we realize that it's a problem.
Well, give us that phone number one more time.
It's 313-230-1119. And you can also visit our website at capitalimpact.org and learn more about the work we do here in Detroit, but also nationwide.
Okay. Melinda Clemens, thank you very much.
Thanks, Steve.
For joining me. Ladies and gentlemen, there is hope for development past downtown. It has started slowly. The balance is not there yet. But if we keep doing things like Capital Impact Partners is doing, we will achieve that balance. The question for you is, can you hold out long enough? And to you young developers, potential developers, you've heard it today. You've seen a way out. You can be a big boy. You can do it. But you have to work. Give Capital Impact Partners a call. You all have a great week. We'll have more compelling television next week. Have a great one.